low-speed taxi was a major milestone for us because it did allow us to check the dynamics of the aircraft under its own power and moving down the runway. 1530 was a definite crawl before you walk. It was a meaningful test in terms of demonstrating the dynamics of the aircraft.
We did a very quick turnaround, as you mentioned, and went back out to do the 90-knot taxi test in the same day. The airplane performed well. We came back from the 60-knot with no pilot squawks. That's almost unheard of. The airplane was flawless.
Janet Schober, welcome to this very special edition of Northrop Today. The day we've worked and waited for finally arrived yesterday when the first flight of our YF-23 Advanced Tactical Fighter took place in front of Northrop Today cameras. This maiden flight is the result of thousands of hours of work by a dedicated team of men and women from both Northrop and Mac Air. Using the words of the people involved, here is a capsule of recent activities that led up to this historic event.
The big one being the development contract for the ATF, the Advanced Tactical Fighter, the jet of tomorrow.
On behalf of the entire team, to present the YF-23.
It's something that we get very excited about, and it's hard when you can't tell anybody about it, and now we'll be able to tell them all.
It's a real experience to see the airplane built from just parts to what we're going to show today, and it's a fantastic feeling to roll it out and to know that you know every little nook and cranny and nut and bolt in that airplane.
We have little pieces of blood, sweat, tears, frustration.
I think every employee working on the program will feel that they're up there with it.
Put a lot of years here, 8.5 years into designing and developing it, and I feel like it's my own baby.
It is very thrilling, very satisfying. I look upon this as the highlight of my career.
Hit a ground, ghost test is coming out of site 23 for taxi.
Ghost test, taxi, approach to 2-2.
I'm part of all this. There's something about me that is flying in that aircraft.
I'd be scared to death, but I wish I could get up in that thing.
Behind the scenes in the mission control room, all the support people that are there are looking at their individual systems and making sure one last time that everything is working well. And then they collectively poll themselves and determine if they've got a thumbs up condition. And that's passed to me and we're ready to go. Time enough to handle any emergencies. And then in fact, on the first flight, we will retract the landing gear. The landing phase is probably the toughest part. It contains the most unknowns. It's the part that you want to pull off well. Again, there's a very intense concentration at that point, trying to fly it on smoothly onto the ground. I've been looking forward to this for 4 years, and a first flight for all my life. But the truth of the matter is, you don't get there alone. I get there because of other people, and our achievements on first flight are due to a lot of people. So I don't pretend to think that I achieve my dream alone. And that's the thing that people should remember. It's never a solitary achievement. It's a group of people. And that's what we did today.